Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to customize the ribbon in Microsoft Word for Mac. The ribbon is the main toolbar at the top of the screen, which is divided into tabs. Within the tabs, related commands are organized into groups. First, we'll add and remove tabs and groups. Then, we'll add commands to custom groups. Next, we'll return the ribbon to its default settings. Finally, we'll collapse and reopen the ribbon. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365 for Mac. These steps also apply to the recent single purchase versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for the web. If you're on a PC, please see last week's tutorial, which will be linked below. To begin customizing the ribbon, select the Microsoft Word menu, followed by Preferences to open the Word Preferences dialog box. Note that you can also open the Word Preferences dialog box with the keyboard shortcut Command plus comma. By default, Word for Mac doesn't display the group names in the ribbon. However, you may want to display them because we'll be referencing them throughout this tutorial. To do so, select View, and then select Show Group Titles, followed by the Back button. Now, select Ribbon and Toolbar, and ensure that you're in the Ribbon tab. To add and remove tabs and groups, select an option from the Customize the Ribbon menu. Main tabs are the tabs that appear when you open Word in Print Layout and Outline view. All tabs are all the tabs available in Word. Tool tabs are the contextual tabs that appear at specific times, such as the Picture Format tab that appears when a picture is selected. Uncheck or check the box next to the tab to remove or add it to the ribbon. To see the groups within the tab, select the arrow next to the name. You can also select the arrow next to the group name to show the commands within that group. To remove a group, select it, and then select the Remove button. Individual commands cannot be removed from the preset groups. Before we move on, it's important to note that the Adobe Acrobat group can't be removed without deleting a backend library file, which is beyond the scope of this tutorial. However, we can cover that advanced topic in the future if requested. In Word, commands can only be added to custom groups. You can add custom groups to custom tabs or the existing preset tabs. To add a custom group to a custom tab, select the Add button, and then select New Tab from the drop-down menu. Next, select the New Tab, which will be labeled New Tab Custom, and then select the More Options button, followed by Rename from the drop-down menu. Next, enter a name into the dialog box and select the Save button. Next, select the new group, which should be automatically created in your tab. And once again, select the More Options button and Rename. And then type a new group name into the dialog box. You may notice that there's an option to choose a symbol for your new group. This feature hasn't worked reliably for me personally, so I'm going to skip that step today. Lastly, select the Save button. To create a custom group in an existing tab, select the tab, and then select the Add button, and New Group from the drop-down menu. Next, select the new group, and then select the More Options button, and Rename. Again, type a name into the dialog box, and select the Save button. Now that we've created a custom group, we can add commands to the ribbon. To begin, select the custom group, and then select an option from the Choose Commands from menu. The popular commands and all commands options will likely be the best choices for most users. From there, select the command, and then select the Add button. Repeat that process until you've added all the necessary commands. Note that you can reorder the commands by dragging them up and down within the custom group. The default commands in the default groups can't be reordered. To remove a command, select it in the custom group, and then select the Remove button. When you're finished customizing the ribbon, select the Save button, and then close the Word Preferences dialog box. Your ribbon customization should appear immediately and should remain in effect until you change the customizations or return the ribbon to its default settings. If you want to return the ribbon to its default settings later on, select the Word menu and then select Preferences. When the Word Preferences dialog box appears, select Ribbon and Toolbar, and then ensure you're in the Ribbon tab. If you want to reset a specific tab, select it in the Tabs menu, and then select the More Options button. From there, select Reset Only Selected Ribbon tab, or Reset All Customizations from the drop-down menu. If you selected Reset Only Selected Ribbon tab, select the Save button. If you selected Reset All Customizations, select the Yes button in the dialog box. Finally, close the Word Preferences dialog box. There are several ways to collapse or hide and then reopen the ribbon. However, one of the easiest ways is to select the View menu, followed by Ribbon in the drop-down menu. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Command plus Option plus R to collapse and reopen the ribbon. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Word for Mac, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to change the proofing language in Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.